I'm Derek Johnson with Tatango.com, and I'm answering the question, what is SMS geofencing? So let's first talk about what geofencing is. Geofencing is usually used when you're talking about mobile apps. What happens with the mobile app is as long as the customer gives the permission to the mobile app manufacturer can track via GPS where the phone is. So this is why, you know, Uber or Starbucks, they'll know where you are when you walk into a store, where you're walking in terms of the location of a pickup of an Uber. And the way they're doing it is by tapping into the phone's GPS. So when people come to us and ask us about SMS geofencing, they think it should be the same, where let's say, you know, one of your customers walks within a 50-foot range of one of your retail stores, you should be able to text message them and tell them, hey, there's a special, come on in. Unfortunately, while it's technically feasible to do that, it's actually financially impossible to do it. So let me explain. Because SMS, unlike a mobile app, does not have GPS enabled all the time and is not sharing that information with the brand, it means that to find out the location of a mobile phone user, a SMS provider would actually have to do a location lookup on the phone. And then it would return the information about that user. Unfortunately, for SMS, unlike mobile apps, each lookup costs a considerable amount of money for the brand. So what this means is that it's technically feasible if you had, let's say, 1 million mobile subscribers that have opted in to your SMS campaign, and let's say those 1 million people were all walking around, and let's say somebody walked into your geofence, which would be, let's say, a mile radius of one of your retail stores. Well, the only way you could do that with SMS is if you are looking up the location of all 1 million of your subscribers 24 hours a day, every single second. And unfortunately, you can't do that because of the cost is extremely high per lookup. So if you're doing, you know, 1 million lookups every single second, you know, during business hours, that'd be hundreds of millions of lookups, which would make it financially impossible to actually do. Which is kind of, you know, upsetting, because it would be really cool if that could actually work, but unfortunately it doesn't. So when people do talk about geofencing for SMS, while maybe they're not using the right terminology, usually what they're saying is they've collected some location data, whether it's where they opted in, and that might be via, you know, a look up on the location, or it might be during the opt-in process they collected the subscriber's zip code. There's a bunch of different ways that you can do it. And then what they'll do is they'll say, okay, today I want to send a message to people within 20 miles of, you know, the zip code 98121, which is here in Seattle. That's usually what they're talking about, even though they're not using the right terminology. That's what they're talking about when they're talking about geofencing for SMS, because unfortunately, it's not able to happen financially, even though it can happen technically. So that's the answer to what is SMS geofencing.